Hi there, my name is Dan, and this is a free clip from my larger Microsoft Word training course. Check out the link in the description or go to bringyourownlaptop.com for more. Hi, in this video we're going to look at getting started with a monthly newsletter for a company. Now there's going to be a lot more tools we're going to learn, but also there's a lot more creativity that goes into it. So if you are maybe new to design, or at least like me, get a bit stuck doing the same old, you need inspiration. Probably the quickest and easiest way is to look to people that are already making beautiful stuff, see what they do, and we're not going to copy, but we're going to kind of use it as inspiration for our own stuff. You'll find I like the term appropriation, okay? By the time you kind of look at the format, you're like, I like that. You changed your fonts, you use your colors, you use your images, your content. It's inspired by, but it's not a direct copy of. The way to get inspiration for your next Word document is to look at great graphic designers. And often this site here, Behance.net, okay, it's where people, we're designers, okay, go and post their portfolios of really good stuff. You could use Google Images. The problem with Google Images is there's just as much trash in there as there's good stuff, whereas Behance tends to have really amazing, beautiful stuff. So come into here, over here on the right type in search, and you could put in company newsletter or whatever you're looking for, or letterhead, but often what I find the easiest one to go to is an annual report. I know we're not making an annual report, but it's the one that people spend a lot of money on and often have a lot of copy to deal with and can be really good kind of inspiration for us. Then you just start going through, and I like to hold down the control key and click on a few of them. So where's he looks good. Okay. If I hold down control while I'm clicking, you can see they kind of open up in their own tabs. You can just click on one by one, it's up to you. So I'm just kind of going through things that I like the look of, and then you just start going through and saying, do I like this? I like the fonts, I like this kind of slab serif here. That's really cool spacing after. It's really cool with this white on black. You might not be able to do white on blacks. So you might do something similar, but with black text on a white background. Okay, that's kind of cool. They've done this columns where the columns start out quite far. So this is the kind of inspiration that I'll sit through and go through and say, I like that, I like that. You know, what do I like about it? This is quite cool. It's all grayscale. Okay, and it keeps printing costs down. Okay, and I've used that corporate color. You might switch over your corporate color, your fonts. I like how it kind of splits across pages. Now I'm just kind of waffling, but you get the idea. Go through these things, find the stuff you like. That's really cool. That kind of slabby color, bit of gradient going on. And then once you get an idea, okay, of what you want to do, you can start building yours in Word. And that's what we're going to do in the very next video. So inspiration done, let's get making. How'd you find that video? Was it good? Was it bad? If you liked it, go check out more of my courses on bringyourownlaptop.com.